Copilot for OneDrive for Business finally lit up in my tenant, so I've got access to it. I've been playing with it. I thought I'd give you a quick hands-on look at this pretty exciting feature. While it's not the most earth-shattering, I think it gives us a great indicator of where things are headed. So let's just jump over to my desktop and take a look. Okay, so here I am on the home of office.com. And the first thing I want to show you, because the first place I went to look for is like, all right, well, there's one of my files. And if you click here, like, we're not seeing the Copilot stuff. So in order for this to light up today, what you need to do is you're going to need to go over here to your OneDrive. Now, once you're in OneDrive, once again, you might be like, well, look, it's, you know, what's going on with this here? And like all of these, they don't have the Copilot. Well, remember, this first look on the home of your OneDrive is actually showing you all the stuff in your tenant. So these are actually a bunch of SharePoint lists. So that is why you're not going to see it. So probably the easiest place to start to see this stuff is under My Files. Now, I will guess I point out real quick that you do have to have the Microsoft 365 Copilot license to have this. So if you don't have that, you're not going to see this. If I log in on my Chewy account, who doesn't have the $30 a month license, he doesn't get it. But I have the license. And so now if we jump in here and go to my box checked HR docs. And so if we look on one of these documents here, we see the cute little Copilot icon. I can click there to start to see the things that are available. So the first one is summarize. So if we click at this, it is going to take that file right now. It's ingesting the file. It's going, and it's using the large language model. It is GPT-4 or 4.0. I'm not sure which one of those it is, but it is going to process that file and then it's going to give us a complete summary. And there goes the summary. And you can see right away that, you know, it's an overview of what's in the document. We don't really care what the words are other than I have checked them. They are accurate. And you'll notice here that it is referencing, as always, what file is coming from. It's obviously that one file. Okay, so that's the first thing, summary of any of your files. Now, reality though, you probably don't really want just the summary, right? Like what you're probably after here is the second feature, which is ask a question down here at the bottom. So if we click this, this is going to load up a Copilot over on the right. And so look over here, now it's like, hey, here's the things I just told you. So it's already, it's like it jumped in mid-conversation. So you asked me to summarize, I've summarized the file. But now if we go down here, we can do things like, hey, you know, tell me more about Buddy Young. Sure, let's just see what it does. And it's going to process that and, you know, take information from the file. So this is just based off of the file that's going on here. And so it's getting the information, in this case, from the welcome message inside of there. And then now we've got all the usual suggestions that we would expect to see here. This is pretty cool, right? So now we can have an interactive chat with the file. And if you go up here and hit the ellipses, you're going to see that there is going to have a chat history. So we can kind of flip through all those. We can delete our history. We get started new chats. And so if we started a new chat, it's like, hey, summarize this file. And then we could, of course, just go down here and do the old slash and then grab any of the files that we would expect, right? So everything working probably the way you would expect it to. And I will note that, you know, even though I am in my OneDrive, like this web power platform AI use cases, a new web page that we're working on actually. Like if you go in there, so that is coming from a SharePoint site, but I'm now in the tool, I can now reference it. And so now it's going to do the same exact thing with a file that's not even in my OneDrive, this is in my SharePoint. Okay, now when the response here, you can see it's like, hey, I couldn't find the file that we just linked to, and it ended up giving me another response. Now, I've ran into this a few times. I feel like there's still some kinks to work out here with the tool. I think that's why it's important that we went hands-on with it. So in this case, if you see that like, hey, it failed, it gave you the wrong file, you can shake your fist angry. But if we go down here and we just try again, right, we pass it that same file a second time, then it is going to do a good job. And even, you know, you can see that like, it doesn't always fail because I then went, if I start another new chat, right? So let's just do another new chat and then summarize this file. And then we'll just do the same exact thing we did a second ago. Odds are pretty good that this time, for whatever reason, it'll be like, oh yeah, you really meant this file. So I've had it a couple times grab the wrong file. Yeah, see, this time it worked on the first try. So just a little nuance there. I'm sure they're going to fix it. I'm sure they already know about it. But there are several places where through my testing, I would tell it to process one file and it would process the file that I'd given it one prompt before instead of that one. So anyway, don't use that to, you know, belittle it. I'm still super excited. Okay. So that's working with an individual file. Another thing that you can do is if you go over here, if we double click on two files, or we could do more, right? But I'm just going to do two. So when you have multiple selected up here, we got Copilot. And one of the things that you can do is you can compare files. Hey, don't forget, I have an upcoming live Copilot AI training class. I have on-demand AI training classes. I am teaching AI privately. It's a lot of demand for that right now. A lot of people want to see these tools, you know, but with just me and a few of their key stakeholders or executives. So we can do any of that for you. Just reach out. You're right. Shane at powerapps911.com. You know how to get a hold of me. All right. Back to the video. So in this case, it's going to look at both of those files. Now, in these two handbooks, basically the difference between the two is going to be that one has a pet policy and one does not. Now, look, it did it again. So here it grabbed the Web Power Platform AI use cases that we just got to respond to and a copy of the employee handbook. Boo. So we'll just close it. We'll hit it again and we'll say compare the files. And so far, knock on wood, every time I've done it a second time, it's been like, oh yeah, there you go. There it is, right? So it says, hey, this file basically doesn't have any pet policy details, right? Not included. This one, there is a pet policy included, and it gives you a breakdown of that, right? The summary is fairly intelligent. Now, I will tell you, like, I've tried to, or not the summary, the comparison. I did try, and one of them, like, so basically these two files are the same exact file. The only difference, I added the pet policy to this one. But then I went back to this one, and I took box checked, right, my fake company, and I changed the name to box checked without a space, right? So it's verbatim, all the same stuff, just instead of box check being two words, it's one. And when I compare the two, it does not catch that. So it's not like doing a word for word comparison. It's more of a overall, hey, what's inside the document, you know, that what you kind of expect of a large language model or a human, right? Like if you gave a human the files, they're probably not looking, you know, word by word for differences. They're reading the two documents being, oh, this one's missing a section. So it is giving you a more natural response, but it is not a more traditional compare these two files and show me every character that is different. Okay. So I wanted to point that out that, you know, the language model is kind of, or not kind of, is doing the processing. It's not the old, just compare these two files line by line and find all the nuanced differences. The other one, the last little piece here, if we click on one file as well, we also, and once again, you know, you've got Copilot here, you got Copilot here, or if you do here, you got Copilot. There's different, you know, it's all the same. Just it surfaced itself in three different ways today. But so if we go here, we can also create an FAQ. And so then this is the same type of thing. It's going to read the handbook. And now it's just making up FAQ questions that would be tied to that particular handbook. So I have not had any strong desires to do that yet. But it's a thought that was interesting if you are in the case. And if you are happy with what it has, or at least feel like it's a good foundation, of course, you can always hit copy here. And now we could go off, make our own Word document, make our own web page, wiki loop, I think is the thing to do today. But you get the idea. So this is the OneDrive for Copilot. They've promised us a bunch of other features. I'm not going to get into any of the forward-looking stuff. Like, this is the stuff that works today and how it works. And that's what I wanted, was that practical approach. But I do think it's really interesting, right? Like we said, this file right here. So Nicola uploaded the new total impact study on the Power Platform, right? So this is on a SharePoint site. So even though it's not in my OneDrive, I can still hit the Copilot icon and go summarize that particular document. So once again, this is super interesting. This is not something I'd really caught on to at the first pass, right? And look, once again, it's like the whole, hey, I don't know what file you meant. Ugh, this seems to happen more than I want. But if we just do the same exact file a second time and say, summarize it, as you can bet, so far I'm 100% of the time, there you go, it found the file. And so now it is giving me all that information. OneDrive Copilot is a entry point. And I, you know, right, like the writing's on the wall. They're going to add this, I'm guessing, in more places. It'll start to light up probably directly in SharePoint. So we can just be in SharePoint and hit the Copilot icon instead of having to kind of get to the file indirectly through OneDrive. But for today, we will take this because I think this is really neat. So questions, comments, thoughts, like, do you like this little quick video, this quick jaunt today, real world look at a new feature? You know, I know a lot of you don't have the Copilot for Microsoft 365 license. I have the fortune of having one. So I try to share this cool stuff so you can kind of continue to justify why you need it and why you should be playing with it, because this is the future of work. So the sooner you start playing with it, the better off you're going to be down the road. All right. With that, I'm going to say thanks. And have a great day.